Hello students, welcome to my channel. Let us solve a problem from GATE 2011 question number 35. A concrete lined non-circular tunnel has a semicircle at the top and a rectangular section at the bottom. The semicircle has a diameter of 6 meter, whereas the rectangular section is 6 meter wide and 3 meter high. The tunnel carries a discharge of 128 meter cube per second. If the frictional factor F is 0.017, then the hair loss in 1 kilometer length of the tunnel in meter will be dash. Let us go to the solution part. First of all, the tunnel is having a non-circular cross section. So here the cross section is having a rectangle as well as a semicircle. Let us see. So the semicircle has a diameter of 6 meter. So let us see, this is the 6 meter diameter, and the cross section of the rectangle is 3 meter high. Let us see, this is 3 meter the height, and the width is 6 meter. So this is the cross section of the tunnel. So this tunnel is having a discharge Q is 128 meter cube per second. So now first of all we will find out the area, cross sectional area, you can see. So cross sectional area, already a total of the tunnel, so will be equal to area of rectangular section plus area of the semicircular section. So area of the rectangular section will be how much? It is 6 meter into 3 meter. This is height into breadth or width, plus semicircular area is pi into 6 square pi d square by 4 into 2, because it's a half of the circle. So that will be equal to that is meter square, so it will be 32.14 square meter, the area of the tunnel. Now coming to the perimeter of the tunnel. So perimeter, weighted perimeter, you can say. So weighted perimeter, if the tunnel is flowing through full, then perimeter of the tunnel will be equal to first of all this lower section, that is 3 into 2 height plus 6 plus pi d by 2. So pi d is 6 divided to half of the semicircle. So the weighted perimeter will be equal to 21.425 meters. So this is the weighted perimeter. So from the weighted perimeter we can calculate the equivalent diameter of the, so equivalent diameter of tunnel. Since this is a non-circular cross section, so this non-circular cross section will be a circular one, so that we can calculate the hair loss. So later this is having a DE, or equivalent diameter of a circle. So we can find out that equivalent of diameter of the circle will be equal to area, weighted perimeter, weighted area divided by weighted perimeter, there is P into 4 times weighted area into perimeter. So 4 times into weighted area, perimeter will be equal to 4 into weighted area is 32.14 divided by 21.425 is the weighted perimeter. So total equivalent diameter will be equal to 6.005 meter. So this is the equivalent diameter of the tunnel. So now we know the Darcy-Weisbach equation and from other things. So we know the velocity, if we know the velocity of the water discharge, then we can calculate the head loss. So for that you have to calculate the velocity. So velocity of the water, or velocity of flow, you can say velocity of flow, let it be, that it is Q by A, area of the cross sectional area of the discharge. So Q is in this case 128 meter cube per second divided by area is 32.14 meter square. So the velocity will be equal to then 3.983 meter per second. So this is the velocity of flow. Now we can calculate the hair loss. Hair loss will be, so HF, that is equal to F L V square by 2GD, DE in this case, your equivalent hydraulic diameter, you can say. So in this case, L is given as 1 kilometer, which is equivalent to 1000 meter, and F is given 0 point, F is the friction factor, that is given 0.017, and G you have to calculate, put 9.81, so let us put, so that therefore HF will be equal to 0.017 into L is 1000 meter into V is 3.983 square divided 2 into 9.8 into 6.005. So therefore calculating this, we can get the head loss will be equal to 2.29 meter. So this is the answer for this question, and the option is C of this question number 35. That is the answer. Hope you get the answer. Please like and subscribe to my channel.